Email sucks. Let's be real. We have extremely long threads. We have to constantly look through what the last thing that was important from somebody was when they emailed us, and it just sucks. That's just kind of is what it is. This video is sponsored by Spike, and while I want to thank them for that, this is my completely unfiltered thoughts and opinions on the application. So what is Spike? Spike is an application that makes your email feel just like chat. Everything is organized by people, so you can see every conversation you had with them in one place. Just like on Messenger, it allows me to view emails in a text chat format and by person rather than as threads, which can be so confusing and hard to keep up with. Often when using email, I feel that I need to scroll through a thread to see what's going on and what email I'm even replying to. What's great about Spike is that you don't have to deal with that. Another great thing about Spike is that it actually helps you reduce your clutter by not having the really annoying signatures constantly shown at the bottom of every message that you send. And the best part is, if you're interacting with someone who doesn't use Spike, it looks like you're just sending them a normal email. Well, you get to see it in chat form. The Spike inbox is also very smart, as it has a priority inbox functionality that sorts what is really needed for you in your day-to-day. I like this as it actually does a great job of figuring out what is more of an urgent email that I need to respond to and what isn't. I also like to utilize the unread filter on my inbox, as I'm someone who mainly cares about what I have not responded to in order to minimize my email inbox in general. As someone who has a business and personal email, it is so annoying to have to go back and forth through the two different emails that I have, but thanks to Spike, I get the unified inbox, which makes my life a lot easier.
As you can see, this unified inbox showcases my emails in one place, while also letting me know what emails were sent to what inbox.
And thank goodness for me, this app has a unified calendar as well. So I have a Google Calendar for my personal and for my business, and that really helps. Because there's a lot of meetings. Not really, but there are some meetings that I need to keep track of. And it's really helpful to have all of my Google Calendar stuff in one specific place.
I have three calendars I'm juggling between personal, Rise Productive, and my Calendly. And as you can see, it's an amazing experience to interact with something like this.
So I like collaborative notes and tasks. I'm a Notion guy, but Spike actually does have collaborative notes. So they actually interact right with your inbox. In Spike, so you can send different notes to other people and collaborate with them. And even if they don't have Spike, they can interact with them just like something like a Google Doc, and they could add comments and see what the different things that you want to communicate with them are, as well as what you assign to them. Because you can do tasks like this, you can do notes like this. It's really nice that I can do this and interact with my email specifically and also have shared notes like connected with those two things. Because if that's the way that I'm gonna communicate with somebody, it's pretty easy to just like keep it in my inbox and then just reference that.
So as you can see, you can actually share different notes and tasks right in the application. And the notes are really collaborative and have real-time interactivity. I don't even have to be a Spike user to interact with one of these. If I open this up in a different browser, it'll work really easily in there. And it's just a really nice note-taking and collaboration experience.
So another nice thing is anytime I'm interacting with people, there are different groups of people that come up, right? So I could have different things like company contacts or different people that are like my YouTube contacts, my YouTube friends, even just personal stuff. I could have these different groups in Spike so that I can just have my contacts be a little bit more organized. But also on the bottom right, if you go to that section, what you can do is you can just see your entire contacts list there, which is pretty convenient. I'm personally a fan of the fact that I can just like scroll through my contacts, click on that, and then see how my last interaction went with one of those people. And as well, you can obviously search at the top and you can find all the emails that you've had with somebody by searching their name, clicking on it, and then you'll see the chat thread that you've had with them over email. So something that I really enjoy is the fact that you can send a voice message to people. So if I were to take this and go, hey, Dimitri, you're doing a great job with this video, but we're gonna need you to get those reports to us by noon because that's your real job. So I can send that to somebody and they could hear the inflection in my voice and understand whether I'm actually like irritated at them or not, or like if it's actually urgent. I feel like sometimes emails are just so blunt and so just formal that they seem to not really give you that feeling of how someone's actually trying to tell you something. So I do enjoy the fact that this is an option. Also, this application is really great in regards to the fact that it has pretty much all the same functionality on your mobile as it will have on your desktop. So if you want to get the mobile app, I think it's great to have the mobile app as well, because let's be real, a lot of us email while we're on the go, and it's a lot easier to interact with it as if it was a chat or messaging app. Thank you again, Spike, for sponsoring this video. If you want to get the application itself, make sure to click the link down below. And with that being said, if you want to see another video on how to improve your productivity, just click this one.